Well, July is the deadliest month for car crashes, and the Centers for Disease Control reports car crashes are the leading cause of death for U.S. teens. Also, many teens are driving cars that don't offer good protection or the latest safety features. Not surprisingly, teens are also more prone to being distracted while driving. Joining me now is Karen Rowling from the Siebert Insurance Agency. Thank you for joining us today.
Sure thing. Thanks for having me.
Well, when I hear some of these stats, it scares me. My oldest right now is 13, so I'm not that far away from the 16-year-old first-time driver. But the risk of car crashes is highest among 16 to 19-year-olds. And I think the stat you told me was 16-year-olds get into 6 times more accidents than older drivers.
Absolutely. If you put 6 16-year-olds in a room, in the next year, one of them is going to get into an accident.
Oh, that is so scary.
Yeah.
And what's the problem?
Distracted driving. They're inexperienced. They're not sure of what to do in a certain situation when a driver, you know, tries to cut in front of them, or just they just don't predict what the driver's going to do. They put too many people in the car. They're not wearing their seatbelt. They're listening to the radio too loud. Don't hear the emergency vehicle. There's all kinds of things that bad things that they'll do.
That leads me to ask, what can parents do? How do we help?
Just educating your child. When you're driving and they're the age that you have, 13, you tell them, you know, while you're driving, why you make a certain move, or look at this driver. It looks like they're going to try to get over. They're looking over their left shoulder, you know, so they can predict what
and model good behavior, I'm guessing.
Exactly. No texting and driving. Try not to talk on the phone while you're driving a car, which I know is difficult. But the texting and driving is really one of the big problems.
Now, there are programs out there that can help.
Absolutely. There's you know, if you just Google teen driving and, you know, what a parent can do, there's all kinds of tips and things like that out there. But there's a teen driving contract that we recommend our clients have their teens sign. And it just says that they're not going to go over the speed limit. And if they do get into a situation where they've, you know, don't feel that they can drive, that they'll call and they're not going to get in trouble, and that they won't text and drive. They'll stay within certain limits, certain boundaries, so they're not driving to Orlando and back in one evening.
That's a great idea, because I saw one of your other stats is when those accidents occur, and it's usually after dark when...
Absolutely, between 9 p.m. and 6 a.m. is when the deadly accidents happen, most of the deadly accidents.
It's so scary. It's just scary thinking about putting your teenager, this child you've been, you know, grooming their entire life, out on the road. So
exactly.
Whatever you can do, I guess I start now. That's what it sounds like.
Oh, absolutely, absolutely. When they get those keys, it's freedom, and you just got to be scared of what they do. So just talking to them is one of the biggest preventative measures you can do.
All right. Thanks, Karen.